Hello, dear Steemians, Dtubers, members of Uptrend, and all beautiful and creative blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. At the very beginning, I would like to mention that if you are on the page of Steemit.com, at the top of the page, you will see this new Steem is live, more here. So actually, this is the post that Steemit Inc. published yesterday, immediately after the hard fork took place. So let's have a look at their post. I just want to say that I'm really very happy that this hard fork 21 took place. And of course, I would like to mention that there were some issues at the very beginning yesterday. I mean, after the hard fork, there were some issues with Steem blockchain, but they were solved very fast by the witnesses and the team of Steem. And that's why I want to say thank you to the Steem community. I just want to mention that last year, when in September hard fork 20 took place, there were some kind of issues at that moment as well. And I think it took a little bit more than 3 or 4 days until everything started to work smoothly. Now we see that the team of Steemit and the witnesses of Steem blockchain, they were able to solve all the issues almost immediately or just within a couple of hours. So great job. So now what I want to say is that, of course, if we have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies, according to the beautiful site of CoinGecko, there has been no significant changes to the prices of the cryptocurrencies for the last 24 hours. But let's have a look at the price of Steem and how it reacted yesterday to the hard fork 21. So this is actually the price chart of Steem for the last 24 hours. So we see that the price has been trading sideways. So once again, the hard fork happened yesterday, and we see that the price was quite stable. We didn't see any high volatility. So that's it about the price. What I want to say is that if we switch to this new Steem is live post, we can find very interesting information. Of course, they will write another post explaining why those issues yesterday they happened, although they had tested the Steem blockchain before. But what I want to say is that they had another, they wrote another interesting post before, in which we can see some explanation about the hard fork 21. So this post was published 2 months ago. I will include the link to this post under my video. What I want to say is that one of the functionalities that will be implemented or have been already implemented is the SteemDAO or SPS. So this is Steem Proposal System. And many Steemians, they have commented recently on this functionality or on this organization or SteemDAO or Steem Proposal System. And I want to say that at first sight, it looks to be something really very beneficial to the Steemians. Let's hope that it will be beneficial to us. And what I want to say is, for example, if we read some information about this SteemDAO, it's written the following. The SteemDAO was a concept proposed by BlockTrades to allow Steem users to publicly propose work they're willing to do in exchange for pay. Steem users can vote on this proposal in almost the same way they vote for witnesses. It uses stake weighted votes, but voters can vote for us for as many proposals as they want. So it sounds really great, and I want to say that, for example, at the moment I'm unemployed, and I explained before in my many videos that I used to work as a cryptocurrency analyst for a big brokerage company in Moscow, Russia, but the company had to leave this business. So our bosses close the company because some regulatory issues in Russia, and we remained without job. And since then I've been unemployed, or as people say, we've been full-time Steemians. But what I want to say is that I am actively looking for some kind of job. It will be really very nice if I found a job in the cryptocurrency field or in the blockchain field, somehow relating to what we like, what we love to do. And I just want to mention that it was probably 2 years ago in 2017 when Cointelegraph, this functionality that they have this jobs portal or platform. So they said at that moment that it will be a nice place for cryptocurrency enthusiasts reading Cointelegraph to be able to find some kind of jobs or a job on this site, on their site. So they launched their platform probably 2 years ago, and it was a platform with a list of jobs opportunities inside blockchain, fintech, and crypto industries. Actually, I've been keeping an eye on this platform, and it has not been doing very well, to be honest. There is not that many opportunities or vacancies. But what I want to say is, I remember when it was announced, probably in 2017 or in 2018, it was a great idea. It was really a great idea to create this ecosystem or platform with job listings in the cryptocurrency world for cryptocurrency enthusiasts. That's why if we come back now to hard fork 21 and the SPS functionality, it would be really very nice if on Steem blockchain we have this sub ecosystem or platform or whatever they call it, a place where people will be able to list some kind of jobs. And if some of us are ready to perform these tasks, for example, to do this jobs, let's say, it will be a nice functionality if there is such kind of place on Steem blockchain where we can find some kind of jobs, or people or employers, they can list their vacancies. And of course it will be very beneficial for all of us. For example, for me it will be very very beneficial as an unemployed person, and of course it will be very beneficial for the employers, because they will have our profiles and they will be able to analyze, to realize who we are. So it's like a CV. So the potential employer, he will be able to analyze or to scan the information about the potential employee. So I think probably we have to initiate this idea. I don't know if you fellas like it, to our witnesses or to people that will be responsible for the new functionalities or etc., to create such kind of place. I don't know if I think it will be something interesting to build on the top of Steem blockchain. So that's it for today about hard fork 21 and my idea. And the last thing I want to mention today is about the beloved Brave browser. So they announced today that they will implement a crypto wallets into Brave. So it will be something similar like MetaMask, and at the moment people will be able, or in the near future, people using this Brave integrated or built by Brave crypto wallets, they call it crypto wallets, they will be able to store Ethereum and probably ERC20 tokens along with, of course, BIT token. So this is really something nice, because I'm an active user of Brave browser. That's it, fellas, for today. I wish you a wonderful day, good luck, and hope to see you in my next video. It was me at CryptoSpa.